So India declared as an independent on a 15th August 1947. The announcement occurred on a midnight of a 14th August when the first Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, it was uttered the famous historical speech, which is known as a very good Christ with Destiny. That speech, which read it by the existing first Prime Minister of India, independent India, in a Constituent Assembly. That Constituent Assembly, which was framed in a British age in 1946 to frame the Indian Constitution, framing of an Indian Constitution. So finally, the Nehru, it announced as India is now as the independent country, which will be not controlled by the any of a colonial power. So after the Indian independence, huge number of changes, these were recorded, which earlier not possible in Indian society. For example, in British age, a large number of sedition acts were passed by the Britishers. One of the sedition act in 1870, which restricted the civil freedoms of individuals. People can't express their views about the government, about colonial government. That sedition act was passed in 1870. As equivalent to the Sedition Act in 1919, another act was passed by the British government. What was the name of it? Very good. Rowlatt Act. Rowlatt Act passed in 1919, which states that in any of a public place, not the two of the individuals, it can be stand or converse, which as a direct attack over the civil freedoms of individuals. So against of which as a Jallianwala Bagh massacre occurred. Indian freedom, independence of India, it was not as an effort of one individual. It was a collective effort of a number of individuals which collectively contributed in independence of India, which are known as the radicalist leaders of a Congress, moderate leaders of a Congress, and revolutionaries. Moderates were those which earlier preferred for the British age. They worked under the British control. Radicals were those which struggled for the freedom of a country from British control. All these moderates and radicals were the parts of the Congress party. But there was one more group was there which already contributed in a Indian independence, contribute in a form of the sacrifice themselves for a nation. These were known as the revolutionaries. In which some of the names are well known as Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad. Can anybody give me the other names? Sardar Vallabhai Patel, it was a Congress person. Revolutionaries, which opted a way of a violence to free the country. Those who sacrificed themselves for a nation. Those which were hanged by the Britishers for their acts. Rajguru, very good. Sukhdev, okay. Any other? Bhagat Singh, accept them. Any other name? Because you all are the assets of our country. Chandrasekhar Azad, very good. Any other? Sarfaroshi Ki Tamanna, who composed that poem, that song? Sarfaroshi Ki Tamanna. Well known patriotic song, Sarfaroshi Ki Tamanna. Yes, online students, there, who composed that poem,
Sarfaroshi Ki Tamanna? Rabindranath Tagore.
No. It was as a Ram Prasad Bismil. His surname also comes in that particular poem at the last. Okay. Ashfaqullah Khan. Any other? Kartar Singh Saraba. Udham Singh, which took as a revenge of a dash incident. Very good. Jallianwala Bagh Massacre, which occurred on 13th April 1919. The partition of a country, which was signed on 14th August 1947 with the formation of a Pakistan. At that time, India, it was known as the how many total number of princely states? At the time of a partition, how many total number of princely states were existed in India? Very good, Dipkiti. 562 states were there. So Britishers, they freed all the 562 states. They neither given the, any of the territorial boundaries to the India or to the Pakistan. Clear? It means all the states were the free. It's a concern of these rulers of the states. They wish to hand over the territories to the India or either to the Pakistan. Okay? It's a concern of them. Because of the endless efforts of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel for making of a modern map of India. Modern map of India by making as a treaties with the Indian rulers, rulers of princely states. The modern map of India, it came into existence. Because of their endless efforts, we known as a Patel as the Iron Man of India. Iron Man of India. Because of their endless efforts for making of the present map of India. That map, which has used in our present administrative units, the partition, the idea of a partition, which was raised by the Muslim League as their leader, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, that partition was based on which idea? What criteria? Very good, religion. Muslim areas separated from the non-Muslim areas. Muslim areas separated from the non-Muslim areas, which was signed by the last Governor General of the Britishers, Lord Mountbatten, which came to India in May 1947. It finally signed a document in which it proved that India, afterwards 1947 onwards, India, it will be as an independent nation, not as a colony of a Britishers. So that's why as the first Prime Minister of India, Bharat ke pehle Pradhan Mantri, Pandit Nehru ji ne, लाल किले की प्राचीर पे चढ़ के भाषण देते हुए उद्घोषित किया आज से भारत स्वतंत्र है. क्लियर? सो हैप्पी इंडिपेंडेंस डे फॉर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ अ ग्लोरियस 74 ग्लोरियस इयर्स ऑफ इंडियन इंडिपेंडेंस. दिस ईयर वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग एज आर 75th इंडिपेंडेंस डे. क्लियर? थैंक यू एवरीबॉडी. एनीबॉडी वांट टू से एनीथिंग? यस, एनीबॉडी? Regarding Indian independence, you all are the assets of our country, as we learned in our chapter. Anybody want to say anything regarding independence? Online students, yes, online. Anybody wish to say anything? Yes, Karanveer, Harmeet, Gagandeep, Dhairya, Bhavansh, anybody? Lisa, Titiksha, you want to say anything regarding the Indian independence? Anybody can contribute? Yes.
Sir, I am.
Yes.
I'm saying our India is the best. Happy Independence Day.
Very good. Thank you.
Proud to be an Indian.
Thank you. Anybody else? Anybody else want to contribute? Stand up. Stay. Thank you. Repeat it.
Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you. During British age, even the press, it was not as a freed by the Britishers. It's also restricted by the Britishers by the enactment of a law. That law, which was named as a Vernacular Press Act, it was enacted in which year? Vernacular Press Act, in which freedom of a press violated by the Britishers. But after the independence, all the different spheres of our life, including as a press, individuals, they can express about their government. In which year the Vernacular Press Act, it was enacted? Yes, online, offline? Dipkiti, Rajesh? Online, yes, 1945, okay. Anybody else? Somebody given the answer, it's a Riyanshika, 1878. Very good, Riyanshika. It's 1878. So let's we continue. Unemployment is a situation in which a person is ready to work at present wages, but unable to find the jobs. When a person unable to find the jobs as per present conditions is known as unemployment. Clear? Unemployment is a threat to the economy, which is responsible for decreasing per capita income. Because a large number of people which are not contributing in economy by production of goods and services, these are also included under the per capita income. If they will also earn the income, then the per capita income simultaneously it will increase. Clear? Unemployment, which has led to the poverty, extension of a poverty in India. Poverty means garibi, nirdhanta. In 74 years of Indian independence, government of India contributed to eradicate the poverty, improve the literacy, improve the health status in India, improving the job opportunities to the governmental schemes. One of the scheme is named as a Manrega, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. This scheme has initiated by government for providing the job opportunities to the villagers through panchayats. Panchayats are responsible to provide as a job opportunities. Any of a work, cleaning, sweeping, or a construction work, any of a work, it has given to the rural people at least through which they can survive. Clear? So in which as a first type we discuss as a disguised unemployment, in which more people are employed as compared to the demand. If we remove the extra workforce in a production site, it neither influence the production. Second, now seasonal unemployment. Seasonal unemployment. Now the second unemployment, seasonal unemployment. It is a situation. Seasonal unemployment is a situation. Seasonal unemployment is a situation in which workers are employed for a particular months of the year. Particular months of the year. And rest of the year, they remains unemployed. Rest of the years, they remains unemployed. For example, in an agricultural sector, people employed at the time of sowing and harvesting season. Workers employed, laborers employed in agriculture sector at the time of sowing and harvesting season. During the time of growing period, for example, presently as a growing period of a paddy is going on. At this time, the workers are not hired by the farmers. They lost their jobs. Again, when the harvesting will begin in October, laborers, it will hire by the farmers for the harvesting of a crop. But in a parts of a Punjab, Haryana, due to the machines, mechanization of agriculture, which led to the large number of workforce became as unemployed. Workers are not required for the farming purposes in parts of Punjab and Haryana. Because of use of machines, combines, threshers, harvesters are there, which reduce as the manual labor. Seasonal unemployment in agriculture. In a industrial sector, seasonal unemployment is related to the production. In secondary sector, seasonal unemployment is associated with production. Certain number of industries are there which hired the workers at the time of a season. For example, hosiery industries of Ludhiana. Hosiery industries of Ludhiana. H-O-S-E-I-R-Y. Sorry, H-O-S-I-E-R-Y, hosiery industries. Hosiery industries which are known for the manufacturing of jackets, gloves, socks, jersey. These are basically known in Ludhiana. So basically they hired the laborers during the time of winters, not in summers. Because at the time of winters, when a demand of a products raised under such circumstances, manufacturers manufacture the such materials which are consumed at their local markets. Clear? Industries. Except then the other industries, when we are talking about iron and steel industries or the other industries, they are also increase or decrease the labor as per the demand of products. When the cotton textile products, these are not purchased by the people, then simultaneously the number of workers will reduce by the entrepreneurs. Agar saman bikega nahi to, then how can an entrepreneur can earn the profits? Then simultaneously it will start to reduce the number of the workers in the production sites. Agar baki sectors ki baat ke, industries ki baat ki jaye. Seasonal unemployment. Any doubts? Till there, any questions? Seasonal unemployment. Next is the technical unemployment. Technical unemployment. It is associated with agriculture. Technical unemployment is associated with agriculture. Agriculture means primary sector. Technical unemployment. Specifically, it has associated with the agriculture. It also lies in a secondary, but widely lies in an agriculture sector. When workers lost their jobs, laborers lost their jobs. When laborers or workers lost their jobs, when workers lost their jobs, due to introduction of newer technology and methodology, technology or methodology in production sites, technology or methodology in production sites is known as technical unemployment. With use of machines in agriculture, earlier in agriculture for sowing of purposes, a large number of workers required for a sowing of wheat and rice, but now that work is done through the machines. Machines are harvest a crop. They clean as a remains of agriculture crops from the agriculture fields. Manual labor is not required. This is as a technical unemployment. टेक्निकल अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट जो काम पहले मैनुअली एग्रीकल्चर में होता था आज वो मशीन से हो रहा है. वन मशीन ऑपरेटेड बाय द वन इंडिविजुअल रिड्यूस द बर्डन ऑफ 20 वर्कर्स इन एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड्स. दिस इज एज अ टेक्निकल अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. सो इन इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर द टेक्निकल अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इज बेसिकली एसोसिएटेड विद द कॉटन टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्रीज. ओनली इन अ कॉटन टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्रीज बिकॉज earlier the work of weaving, it was as a manually done by the people. Weaving process. But now with the introduction of a spinning jenny in 18th century, at the last decade of 18th century, spinning jenny, spinning, spinning jenny, jenny, spinning jenny. Now weaving process, it started through the machines. Through the machines, they can manufacture the clothes easily in a speedy way. This is as a technical unemployment. Next, educational unemployment. When workers are not getting jobs as per their Navya, speed theek hai, jaya to nahi hai. Continue. Educational unemployed, when workers when workers are not getting jobs as per their professional skills and qualifications, they are not ready to work at low wages is known as educational unemployed. As I told you, if the mechanic is there, elite mechanic is there, in the other side a mechanical engineer is there, both are getting as the same salaries. So under such circumstances, a mechanical engineer is not agreed to work in a production sites. It will refuse to continue their jobs. Clear? So that's why a large number of workforce, it has drained out towards developed countries for a better future. Brain drain occur in India, basically as a professionally qualified. As per one average, every year, approximately 4,000 doctors and engineers, these are moving towards European countries every year. Average figure. Kisi saal jyada bhi ho sakta, kam bhi ho sakta, every 4,000. Near about 4,000 every year, these are displacing from India towards developed countries. America, Canada, European countries, in such countries for a better future as educated unemployed. And last unemployment is a structural unemployment. structural unemployment. Structural unemployment. Structural unemployment. When workers lost their jobs, or removed by entrepreneurs, entrepreneur means industrialist, entrepreneurs, Brijesh, entrepreneur, they will categorize under which form of capital? In first chapter, we learned some of the forms of capital. Which form of capital entrepreneurs lies in which category of capital? Working capital, physical capital, working capital. Very good. Kyun kaha working? Because it can be as an increase or decrease as per the conditions. सामान ज्यादा बिक रहा है, प्रोडक्शन ज्यादा चाहिए, ज्यादा प्रोडक्शन के लिए ज्यादा लेबर चाहिए. सामान बिक नहीं रहा है, प्रोडक्शन को डिक्रीज किया जाएगा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लॉकडाउन, ड्यूरिंग दीज टू इयर्स ऑफ अ लॉकडाउन, मोस्ट ऑफ द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट्स, दे स्टॉप देयर प्रोडक्शन. अब प्रोडक्शन नहीं हो रही है तो हाउ कैन अ एंटरप्रेन्योर कैन अर्न द प्रॉफिट्स? प्रॉफिट होगा तो देन इट कैन पे द सैलरीज टू देयर सर्वेंट्स, टू देयर लेबरर्स. सो दे रिलीज अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ द वर्कफोर्स फ्रॉम द प्रोडक्शन साइट्स under this time period of lockdown, because production affected, production of goods affected. When production is not raised, what will be their impact on economy? Iska impact kya padta hai? Agar production kam ho rahi hai, under such circumstances, what will be their impact on economy? Online, offline, both. Who will answer? If the production is not in normal as per the previous years, then what will be their impact on economy? Chalo, unemployment hogi, jobs kam ho jayegi, poverty bhi hogi. Uske ilawa, maine kaha production kam ho rahi, money nahi aayegi. Maine kaha production kam ho rahi hai to uska markets pe kya impact padega? Lo, aise batao, markets pe kya impact padega? लोगों को, वेरी गुड, इन्फ्लेशन, हाइक इन प्राइसेस. इफ द सप्लाई, यस ब्रिजेश, वेरी गुड, करेक्ट आंसर. इफ द प्रोडक्शन इज नॉट एडिक्वेट एज पर एज अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रीवियस ईयर, देन इट विल इंपैक्ट ऑन अ प्राइसेस. जब सप्लाई एडिक्वेट ना हो कंपैरेटिवली डिमांड, सप्लाई कम हो जाए डिमांड के कंपैरेटिवली, प्रोडक्शन ही हो रही तो सप्लाई कहां से होगी? इट विल इंपैक्ट ऑन अ प्राइसेस ऑफ गुड्स, सामान महंगा हो जाएगा. ठीक है ना, वेरी गुड ब्रिजेश, इन्फ्लेशन, गुड बॉय ब्रिजेश. सो स्ट्रक्चरल अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, व्हेन वर्कर्स लॉस्ट देयर जॉब्स ड्यू टू इनसफिशिएंट कैपिटल मींस इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट नॉट हैविंग द मनी, हाउ कैन इट विल पे टू देयर वर्कर्स? इट विल स्टार्ट टू रिलीव द वर्कर्स फ्रॉम देयर वर्किंग साइट्स. इनसफिशिएंट कैपिटल. सेकंड, लैक ऑफ रिसोर्सेस. वेट प्रतीक्षा, लैक ऑफ रिसोर्सेस. कैपिटल इज नॉट एडिक्वेटली ओन्ड बाय द एंटरप्रेन्योर. पहले उसने लोन से काम चलाया था, अब लोन मिलना बंद हो गया, हाउ कैन इट विल कंटिन्यू द प्रोडक्शन? Second, as a lack of resources. If the raw material has not having by the entrepreneur, how can it will produce the goods? If the goods are not produced, how can it will earn the profits and give their share to their laborers? It will start to decrease the number of the laborers. Lack of resources. Maine second hi bola abhi. Insufficient capital. Second, as a lack of resources. Lack of resources. Lack of resources. Is known as structural unemployment. Structural unemployment. It has exist in all the sectors. It can be exist in a primary sector, secondary sector, or a tertiary sector. Aapne news suni hogi. Idea merge in a Vodafone. Idea telecommunication company. It merge in a Vodafone. बन गया. वेरी गुड ब्रिजेश, वेरी गुड बॉय. नॉलेजेबल अवेयर्ड, ठीक है, क्यों हुआ, बिकॉज ऑफ प्रोडक्ट आइडिया नोन फॉर द सर्विस टेलीकम्युनिकेशन सर्विसेज, उसका प्रोडक्ट या उसकी सर्विसेज दीज वर नॉट एडिक्वेट, पीपल मूविंग टुवर्ड्स अदर नंबर ऑफ टेलीकम्युनिकेशन सर्विसेज, एयरटेल बीएसएनएल उनकी ओर, जियो उनकी साइड का, सेल्स कम हो गई, बिकॉज ऑफ द लॉसेस अ कंपनी इट सोल्ड आउट बाय द एंटरप्रेन्योर टू द अदर कंपनी, नाउ इट बिकम्स एज अ वी, एज ब्रिजेश सेड, वी आइडिया बिकम्स एज अ वी, थैंक यू ब्रिजेश, यस प्रतीक्षा योर क्वेरी, प्रतीक्षा रेज योर हैंड, प्रतीक्षा, यस बच्चे, प्रतीक्षा, द कॉजेस ऑफ अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इन इंडिया, व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इन इंडिया, इलिटरेसी, इलिटरेसी, पीपल आर अनएजुकेटेड, सो दे आर नॉट प्रोफेशनली क्वालिफाइड, दे आर नॉट प्रोफेशनली क्वालिफाइड, दैट्स व्हाई द दीज आर नॉट गेटिंग द जॉब्स, क्लियर. Second, over dependence on primary sector. Over dependence on primary sector. A large number of the workforce directly and indirectly dependent on primary sector. Primary sector. Directly means they are directly dependent on agriculture. Indirectly? Indirectly means what? Directly and indirectly, they are dependent on primary sector. Directly means they are dependent on agriculture for production of crop. Indirectly? Very good. Agro-based industries. Very good, Brijesh. Cotton textiles as an example of agro-based industries. So that workforce which has employed in a small-scale agro-based industries, which are employed, these are the indirect form of a dependence on agriculture. If the production has not reached, production not raised in agriculture, then their products, how can it has consumed in agro-based industries? Very good, Brijesh. Very good. Indirectly, as a agro-based industries impact on unemployment. Third, lack of job opportunities. Yeah, fir keh sakte hain, underdeveloped secondary and tertiary sectors. Underdeveloped secondary and tertiary sectors. Next, we will continue it.